In this video, we're going to be talking about curvature tool, which is added recently to Adobe Photoshop as well. And it's quite new also in Adobe Illustrator. And this tool could be making your drawing experience even better and much, much easier, especially with curves. As you can see, it's called the curvature tool for a reason. And so if you start drawing your anchor points like that, and by default, you're going to be dropping another anchor point, maybe here or there. And once you release, you're going to be having that curve appearing, which means that your straight line will be converted into that curve once you select your next anchor point. So you can be pressing maybe shift and going for quite a circle like this, maybe, and so on. So this tool will usually try to make your curves a little bit smoother like that. And you can be drawing in a freeform way as well, maybe dragging your anchor point in here and going like that. And you can be pressing Alt or Option key anytime. And you're going to be seeing that forward slash symbol, which means you can be drawing straight lines. So maybe like that. And you can be going all the way to close your path. And the cool thing about that tool that you can be readjusting your anchor points anytime you would like. So you can be using the same tool to change your anchor points locations simply by dragging them around like that or readjusting your curves. Of course, after you've got your path drawn like that, you can readjust that one by your anchor point tool from here, or even by add anchor point tool or delete anchor points. And I can drag around to start adjusting my shape and maybe use the direct selection tool to drag this one a little bit like that. And I can be readjusting my shape to make it more accurate, because curvature tool is not as precise as the bend tool. So you might need to work your anchor points even later after you've got them drawn. And let me show you guys a quick application of that tool on drawing Apple's logo. For instance, I'm going to delete that one and maybe that circle too in here. And I will switch that layer to draw the same logo on top. And as you can see, that logo is already built on golden ratio aspect. I'm going to be using curvature tool and start placing my anchor points. And before you start drawing, make sure that you've got your snap to grid off. So we're going to be inserting our anchor point in here. Maybe we're going to be starting in here. Then I'm going to be placing another one in here and also another one. Maybe some other in here. We can be placing them randomly like that. Then we can readjust them easily later. Then we can be closing our shape and maybe add another point in here and drag it like that. And we can start adjusting these points around, maybe to make them a little bit better and more precise. And now, as you can see, we've got our logo almost drawn, except for these parts, we need to readjust them, maybe holding our anchor point tool or direct selection tool. We're going to be using both of them to adjust these anchor points in here, maybe that one. Clicking on that anchor point to get rid of handles. Let me change my stroke color to make it even more obvious to you guys. Maybe changing to cyan. And we need also to readjust these handles, maybe like that. And dragging that one only. And we need to get rid of that handle in here and drag that one a little bit like that. And if we turn off our image, we're going to be seeing that our logo is almost finished, except for that little part in here. We can do that very easily by drawing two circles like that in here. I've got them already on that layer in here, drawing two circles like that, then selecting them and going to Pathfinder, and you can select to intersect, and you will be having that part also ready for you. And let me hide our layer in here and let me change these colors to black, then swapping them, shift X. And as you can see, guys, we've got our logo drawn with curvature tool in a very short time. So this tool could really save you lots of time, especially if you're not so familiar with pen tool. But I really recommend that you practice on pen tool and master pen tool. And once you master the pen tool, you're gonna be able to control even curvature tool and all other tools in a much easier way. So now it's your turn, guys. You can be downloading that logo and start practicing right now.